This week, it's an indoors trip to the tackle shop. The magic behind the making of this crankbait is my motive.
All right.
James Marshall is today's host with the most to show me how to turn balsa into bait.
So, James, you're telling me we're going to take this and turn it into this.
Yep, and it won't take but about 50 seconds.
Okay. What do I need to do?
All you got to do is stick that piece of wood in that square hole.
Okay.
And push it till it stops.
Feed it right in.
Okay. That's good, and then we'll turn the machine on and we'll see what happens.
Sure enough, this mighty machine whittles the wood into a future weapon for the water.
Now that's the finished product as far as cutting it out.
I made that.
You made that.
Now that's a good piece of machinery that can do that automatically. Now let's get to the painting.
Okay.
Okay. Steer me the right way.
You can do it. You just pick out your colors and I'll show you how to do it, and you can paint one and maybe catch fish on it.
All right. Let's do it. Straight down the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Not
too close.
Okay. A little too much, wasn't it?
Yeah.
James gets me to steady my hand enough to coat the back, dot the eyes. Now it's time to seal the deal.
Okay. Yeah, dip it and bring it right out and hang it right over top of it.
Turn around. Beautiful.
Now that makes it shine. And also it makes it durable.
Talk about a great teacher. James gets a lot of satisfaction out of this.
To go out on the lake and actually throw the bait you made and catch a fish on it, that's what makes it rewarding. Plus, when you hear people talk about them and they catch fish on them and stuff like that, it makes it worthwhile.
What may surprise you is James's take on which color works best.
I don't think color makes the biggest difference. Majority of the time, it's the action of the bait, the depth that you want the bait to run, and your presentation.
Good advice and a nice craft lesson as well. In Kernersville, I'm Austin Cavanis. That's this week, Indoors.